He gave the document to his driver to take to the Central Committee building.
A difficult situation. I had to assume the Politburo would read it and say, that's not what we asked for. It gave me a funny feeling. What's going to happen? Will you still be at your desk tomorrow or somewhere else altogether?
But the matter was now out of Gerhard Lauter's hands. The document arrived at the Central Committee building shortly after midday. At this moment, GDR leader Egon Krenz was discussing inter-German relations with senior West German politician Johannes Rau. After the talks, Krenz returned to the Central Committee meeting with Gerhard Lauter's paper. He changed the order of business and read out the note verbatim. Including the passage inserted by the working group about permission being granted to travel abroad without the need to provide reasons for the journey. No one in the room grasped the import of the paper, that it granted freedom of travel to all East Germans. The Central Committee nodded the document through without discussion. Finally, Krenz mentioned the embargo till 4 a.m. on the 10th of November. One member of the Central Committee was missing, though, Günter Schabowski.
I wasn't present. It was while I was absent from the Central Committee meeting.
He returned only shortly before the press conference.
I arrived back in the Central Committee meeting, and all this had happened in the meantime. I sat next to Krenz, and the discussion continued. And then he passed me the note and said, almost in a whisper, take this with you to the press conference.
The one thing that Egon Krenz didn't mention was that the paper was embargoed till the following morning.
I knew nothing about any embargo.
And so Günter Schabowski made his way to the press conference. About 200 journalists from around the world were present. One of them was the distinguished NBC journalist Tom Brokaw.
Yeah, I'm pretty exhausted at this point. It's 5 o'clock. I've flown on Monday night. So I said, is our satellite capability still there? And they said, yes. And we're also getting a crane out there to put a camera over a high shot.
Newspaper reporter Peter Brinkmann had kept his seat.
The room was packed. We had no idea what would happen. But we all had this odd feeling that it was important to be there. Tonight, something's brewing.
At this moment in Poland, Chancellor Kohl was meeting Lech Wałęsa.
We had talks with Wałęsa in which he said, Mr. Chancellor, what's happening now in the GDR will lead to German reunification. Wałęsa was convinced that that would be the outcome.
East Berlin, 6 p.m., the end of the working day in the GDR capital. Richard and Rita Bratfisch turned up for choir practice. They were to run through Christmas carols.
We'd finished work and were glad it was Thursday. Off to the choir, practicing Christmas carols. You have to start in November or October.
Günter Schabowski opened the press conference on the dot of 6 o'clock.
Ich bin Günter Schabowski, Mitglied des Politbüros und Sekretär des ZK. Ich darf Ihnen wieder meine Kollegen vorstellen. Genossin Elga Labs, Mitglied des Zentralkomitees und Vorsitzende der Gewerkschaft Unterricht und Erziehung.
For a full 50 minutes, Schabowski blustered on about the party meeting, saying nothing on the subject of the freedom to travel.
I was tired. It was late in the day, and I'm kind of about half nodding off. He's droning on in his bureaucratic way.
The Bornholmerstrasse border crossing. Harold Jaeger headed to the canteen for his evening meal. Sausage and a roll.
In the canteen, the television was on, but no one was paying any attention to it. I saw the press conference was on, so I thought, I'll watch to see if there's anything new.
Just before it was due to end, the press conference suddenly took an unexpected turn. A journalist asked about the GDR travel law.
Ich heiße Ricardo Ehrmann, ich vertrete die italienische Nachrichtenagentur ANSA. Herr Schabowski, Sie haben vom Fehler gesprochen. Glauben Sie nicht, dass es war ein großer Fehler, diesen Reisegesetzentwurf, das Sie haben jetzt vorgestellt vor wenigen Tagen?
At that moment, I went hot all over. My God, I was supposed to talk about that, about the travel ruling.
He started riffing through his papers and for a while couldn't find the note that Krems had handed him. He had this great pile of papers with him.
And I was searching through this pile for the paper I was supposed to read out. And then a member of staff came and helped me.
Somebody handed him a piece of paper from the Politburo, and he took out his glasses and he read it. And I later described this in the New York Times as if a Martian had arrived on that stage with a message, because it seemed to have come from some other reality.
The message that, against the will of the Politburo, had been worked out that morning.
Also Privatreisen nach dem Ausland können ohne Vorliegen von Voraussetzungen, Reiseanlässe und Verwandtschaftsverhältnisse beantragt werden. Die Genehmigung werden kurzfristig erteilt.
Dann rufe ich. I shouted out, when?
Wann?
Das tritt nach meiner Kenntnis ist das sofort. Unverzüglich.
Und da blieb man da bis zum Halsstecken. I nearly choked. Immediately. I sprang up from the table, leaving my meal, and said, what sort of mental diarrhea is this?
Also doch, doch, ständig Ausländer können über alle Grenzübergangsstellen der DDR zur BRD bzw. zu Berlin-West erfolgen.
Meanwhile, Gerhard Lauter was still discussing his paper.
At 1857, the Justice Minister suggested a change in the text, but I convinced him that our formulation made more sense. So, at 1857, I was still on the phone, unaware that at 1854, Schabowski had already made the document known internationally. It hadn't even been passed by the government.
Shortly after, Lauter left his office. Still in the belief that, because of the embargo, people could not start applying for travel visas until the next morning.
The press conference ended at 7 p.m. All the journalists were still trying to weigh up what they'd just been told.
What did it mean? Wall of... All very
back from the canteen, Harald Jaeger frantically tried to get clarification from his superior officer. He said, I know him. Yes, I think that's the one. They said, you know the instructor. They have nothing to do with the fact that there exists in stipulation. The leadership of the GDR knew nothing about this. All senior party functionaries were still
in the Central Committee meeting. None of them had watched the press conference. In Warsaw at this moment, Chancellor Kohl was attending a ceremonial banquet. He too was uninformed as to what was happening in East Berlin.
The room was abuzz, and then Schabowski folded up the paper, put it back in his pocket, and left the stage. I went out, ran upstairs with my camera crew, and we were in a small room with Mr. Schabowski, who was completely calm and collected. And I said, "Do you still have that piece of paper?" And he said, "I do." And I said, "Well, read it again." So he took it out, put on his glasses, read it again. And I said that that means citizens from the East can go out of the wall any way that they want to.
They are not further forced to leave GDR by transit through another country.
It is possible for them to go through the wall at some point.
It is possible for them to go through the border.
I ran downstairs, and there was a collection of American newspaper correspondents who were friends of mine. And I looked at them and I said, "It's true, the wall is down."
Minutes later, the news hit the TV screens in East and West.
Guten Abend, meine Damen und Herren. Ausreisewillige DDR-Bürger müssen nach den Worten von SED-Politbüro-Mitglied Schabowski nicht mehr den Umweg über die Tschechoslowakei nehmen.
Within minutes of Schabowski's statement, the news started to spread through East Berlin. Just one small group of East Berliners celebrating the news bombshell. And the news sped around the world.
We were certainly very delighted at what was happening, but it also did cause some nervousness. Was there a situation which was going to get out of hand, where East German border guards going to understand what Mr. Schabowski had said?
At around 2 in the afternoon local time, US President George Bush was informed of what was happening.
We didn't know what the nature of this decision on the East German side was. We had to anticipate that there might be a sharp military reaction. So it was very confusing.
Confusion, too, in the Soviet embassy, where the only information available was from the media.
We knew absolutely nothing about it. We were glued to the television. There was disappointment, as well as a degree of anger. The danger was very great that someone would lose their nerve.
In the past 30 years, over 100 people had been killed along the Berlin Wall. It had been a lethal border, and potentially still was.
I didn't have to wait long for the East Germans to arrive. After about 20 minutes, the first arrived and asked if they could leave. The officer asked if they had passports and visas. "No," they said. "But didn't you hear Schabowski? He said we could leave immediately."
While the incendiary nature of Schabowski's note was becoming apparent, its author, Gerhard Lauter, was at the theater with his wife.